evening. Thank you for joining us for our farewell mass for Bishop Gruss. As you enter this evening, you should have picked up the gotten a hand of worship aid. We invite you now to use that worship aid and join in singing the song of four directions as we smudge in preparation for our tonight's mass.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Sing and rejoice, O daughter Zion. See, I am coming to dwell among you, says the Lord. Many nations shall join themselves to the Lord on that day, and they shall be his people, and he will dwell among you, and you shall know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. The Lord will possess Judah as his portion in the Holy Land, and he will again choose Jerusalem. Silence called in the presence of the Lord, for he stirs forth from his holy dwelling. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. While Jesus was speaking to the crowds, his mother and his brothers appeared outside, wishing to speak with him. Someone told him, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside, asking to speak with you." But he said in reply to the one who told him, "Who is my mother? Who are my brothers?" And stretching out his hand toward his disciples, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. For whoever does the will of my heavenly Father is my brother and sister and mother." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
To reveal and expose one's heart to another. receive it. It expresses clearly our love and devotion. So then, who is more perfect and a more powerful person to entrust our lives other than Our Lady, right? As the most tender mother, we must learn to always confide in Our Lady. Why? Because she teaches us how to do the will of our Heavenly Father. We heard that in the Gospel. Who is my brother, sister, mother, the one who does the will of the Father? Mary, our mother, forms us. We entrust ourselves to her. And forms us as beloved disciples of her Son Jesus. Because she was the first disciple. As one who is full of grace, Our Lady of Mount Carmel protects us from the evil one. All need that. Even when it's alive and well in our culture, in our world today, we need this protection. So she protects us from the evil one and is our sure recourse for her maternal intercession. And we not only confide in close friends, but we also abide in communion, in the communion of friendship with them. So to abide, I'm just encouraging you, if you don't have this relationship with her, ask her for it. Ask her for it. Because she wants to give it to you more than you want it. Because if she leads us into discipleship, deeper into a life as a disciple of Jesus, that's not easy. That's not easy. But Mary's whole life was devoted to the honor and the service of her beloved Son. So if you think about it, it's the way she lived her life. She is our greatest inspiration. And she can teach us many things, and wants to teach us many things. So confiding in Mary and abiding in the graces she obtains for us is a sure and steady road to our salvation, our happiness, and our deepest fulfillment. She is the one whom I entrust my transition to this new diocese. She is the one who can guide me in this new mission. Saginaw, Michigan. But she is also the one who this diocese can entrust to finding a new bishop. Think about that. ask her to intercede for this cause. And she will do it. Because she loves you. She wants to protect you. And she wants Jesus to send the person who is her father. And certainly from my experience, and I've had a lot of different experiences in priesthood. You know, out of 25 years, I was only in the parish like 10 and a half. So there's a lot of other assignments I've had along the way. And I believe that every assignment forms us for the next one. Unless it's retirement. And maybe even then it does. You know, I wish there were other things I wish I could have accomplished. And there are many things here I wish. But I do give thanks and praise to Almighty God, truly, for allowing me to be a part of your lives. What a gift I've received from all of you. My love for you and your support for me truly has been an expression of God's love for us. You, God, oftentimes loves us through the people he places in our lives along the pathway of faith. In fact, we are molded by the love and the care of our concerned brother. We are molded pottery in the Lord's and the potter's hands. And one of my favorite quotes comes from a French novelist. He's a poet and journalist. His name is Francois Mauriac. He said, we are molded and remolded by those who have loved us. And though that love may pass, we remain nonetheless perfect. No love, no friendship can ever cross the path of our destiny without leaving some mark upon it forever. How beautiful is that? How beautiful is that? So thank you for leaving your mark upon me. Thank you for sharing your lives with me. I'm serious when I say I have been forever changed by this time that I've been able to spend with you these last years. You know, in many tangible ways, you and the Lord, of course, have taught me how to be a bishop and a shepherd. And this is my first episcopal assignment, so thank you for this. You know, I came in here with like a deer in the headlights. Right? Seriously. You know, I came right in one person, TV. I knew nothing about being a bishop. And truth be known, I prayed it would never happen. But the Lord doesn't listen. also take leave knowing of my own deficiencies and my own sinfulness. And I believe that love is reflected in seeking and offering forgiveness. So, my dear friends, if I have offended or hurt any of you, knowingly or unknowingly, I'm deeply sorry. I apologize and humbly ask for forgiveness. So finally, as I thank all of you in conclusion, I thank you, the wonderful people of the Diocese of Rapid City. I thank you for your prayers and your support. And again, all that you've given me over these last 8 years. This departure does bring about a big hole in my heart that will remain for some time. But what will also remain is this. Generosity of God, his reckless generosity that I've experienced in being a bishop. And so as I take leave on Saturday, as I'm going out, allow me to ask one more thing. Please continue to pray for me, because I love you. And may the Lord send you
for the Church, that the efforts of the Holy Father and all Church leaders will bring about healing and renewal. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Bishop Gruss, as he prepares to become the Bishop of Saginaw, that he will take with him the love of the people of our diocese and experience Spirit in his new ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Diocese of Rapid City, that we will allow gratitude in our hearts for the ministry of Bishop Gruss to lead us to a deep trust in the guidance of the Holy Spirit as we prepare for our new shepherd. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they would seek peace and a desire to work together to bring hope and healing to a divided and broken world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering in body, mind, and spirit, that the love of God ministered through those who care for them will bring them peace and hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they might know the embrace of God's eternal love and rejoice in the fullness of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we praise you, glorify your love and mercy. We come to you in our weakness and our neediness. they may be